For those of you who don't know Scroll, a quick introduction. We have been around for 3 years. We reach around 11 million uniques in India. We have three brands, Scroll, one brand in Hindi called Satyagraha, and we work with Quads, the Atlantic Media's business publication in India. And what I'm going to talk today about, two arguments. Number one, we feel there's a huge opportunity in India for brands to use content as a way of connecting with the audience. And this is even more so in India, where the display ads are of terrible quality. Content ads have been, again, largely product plugs that all of us have seen on our websites. For the last year and a half, we have worked with, I think, 25 plus of the best brands in India, including auto clients like BMW and Volkswagen, pharmaceuticals like Abbott. So everything that you'll see today, the data you'll see is based on our not just the fact that this is what we think should be, but this is what we have observed. And I think there are big points of differences between the way the rest of the world has worked and the way India is evolving. And to me, the biggest point of difference is the likely early adopters of a branded content approach are quite different. Because the scale in India, again, this is my bias, I'll sort of lay down, top down what I think the numbers are. Of the 300 million or so people who are supposedly on the internet in India, I think there are 150 million who constantly use it, right? And of those 150 million, there's a spectrum in terms of languages and engagement. But they are probably some of the most intense users of the internet. So if you see the data that Google releases, these 150 million, just 10% of the population. The corollary of that, though, is that if you look at it from an FMCG perspective, there are many other options to reach the audience. There are, you know, typically an FMCG is looking at a 600 million people sort of solution. And so to me, the corollary of that is the early adopters, and that's what we have seen of branded content in India, are companies that are selling durables, they are selling more expensive solutions, which has many implications for what we do next. So the data I'm going to share with you is a global executive data with a lot of Indian respondents to them as well, to make the first argument as to what is the context. Everyone knows this, but it's worth sort of emphasizing that, okay, right now on this, it doesn't show, but essentially what that shows is 70% of the audience is coming from mobile. And we all know that this is growing, but if you look at the way advertising is designed, even though this is a fact that we all accept, it's not really designed to be mobile first. So the other big surprise for us is what works. I think somebody had asked the question, what are the kind of things that work from a content perspective? This chart should actually tell you a little bit. There are two surprises. Number one, the degree to which people are actually interested in data visualizations, charts. Yes, everybody is interested in videos, but if you look at the type of content that does well, that people are willing to share. And this is across both branded content as well as you know, content. So the other surprise is, and this is a question that often gets asked, which is, are people willing to share? And this, in a way, is a slightly harder test because we have asked executives about this. We know already from the data that we have about branded content that people are actually more than willing to share. So, you know, it's not that people do not share branded content. So the second question is really, okay, people are willing to share, but what are the kind of topics that they're interested in, right? Not a big surprise, but still, this is something that takes a lot of working with the clients and brands to convince them, right? It's not about your product. People are interested, will share if they're interested in that topic, right? So again, the three things I've said so far, like mobiles is where all the action is. People are interested in sharing, open to sharing, but what they're willing to share are things that are of interest to them. Based on these, here are the five things that we try and talk about. Number one is, A, it has to work on phones. While people like to learn about ideas, they prefer to share things. Talking about what you're good at. And we have seen time and again on the data, I'll share the data with you later, but essentially for us, our the branded pieces, we have almost 3 or 4 times the reads of the, in terms of time spent, of the editorial content. And the reason people share is if a brand has authenticity and you know, reputation for a certain things. For example, one of our most shared ads is the Volkswagen ad about safety, right? And VW has credibility on safety, and therefore people, when you have an article that's talking about why car safety in India needs to be thought of before you buy that snazzy leather seats, it actually makes sense. So the third point is, to me, the crux of it, right? That if we are going to create branded content that flies on social media, is read, it needs to be on something that actually connects with the brand's identity. Fourth, of course, we need to talk about things that people care about. And this is the creative magic that needs to happen between the brand's specific campaign and what is it that can connect to. So as we give some examples, we can talk about that. The fifth thing is, again, something that we saw, BuzzFeed also make this point, there are tons of platforms that are emerging. There's no reason that all these experiences would be on Scroll or BuzzFeed. Majority of them would be on other platforms. The key is, how do you actually create pieces of content that work for each of those platforms, and what's that central message that you're going to work with? The topic that I wanted to talk about was owning a conversation. And so this is the second part of the argument. So the first part being that, yes, people do share branded content. It's an important part of your set of things you as a brand should be doing. The second is that there are opportunities to actually own the conversation on some topics, right? And what is a conversation? So this is a definition of it, right? So the kind of conversation that people are interested in, I'll take like recent example two from India, right? Right now, because of all the changes in US visa policy on all, Indian IT is a topic that a lot of people are interested in, right? And I'll take a second topic, which is less controversial, which is smart cities, right? There's a lot of interest in India in smart cities. Now, these are the kind of topics that we feel that brands can own, in the sense that they can make sure that they can design a campaign that not only has original content they have developed, they could curate content from other sources, they can essentially create events, there's a whole bunch of things they can do. And the reason this is a complex argument is that both publishers like Scroll or BuzzFeed and others, as well as the brands, are not used to thinking of the problem in this particular way, right? What it means is that, if Scroll or any publisher goes to a brand, the idea is, okay, we are selling a certain idea and selling some inventory, right? So we have to get away from that notion. So we have to get away from the notion that, the problem we are trying to sell is saying, how should we put three ads on, smart cities on Scroll? So one of the arguments we made earlier was, if conversations are the place, is the way to think about how to engage the audience. The second is that essentially things is what people share. They don't share abstract ideas. To build on the smart city idea, people are not going to share, here are the 25 things about smart cities. It's less likely that people will share that and saying, here are the 5 things that made smart cities real in Berlin, right? A low-cost parking meter is what it took, right? People will share that far more and then read about the broader idea of what a smart city is than an essay on smart cities. So we have a list of things, and of course, things can be anything. It doesn't necessarily have to be a factoid, right? It could be a chart that shows a clear trend, a photo that you should look at. We have all seen this kind of content, but we haven't seen this being used by brands in a powerful way yet. So there's an opportunity to think, A, beyond the listicles, beyond viral videos, beyond saying I'm doing one or two things, to say, okay, I'm going to create a conversation around a certain topic, and I'm going to have all kinds of things that make people talk about it. This is to amplify the point I made earlier, that people are interested in seeing content from brands, and they are interested in it if they think that they're going to learn something from it, right? So the sharing phenomenon that we see is that, and this, again, cuts across India and everywhere else in the world, but people share things that confirm some of their intellectual biases, right? And the best way to do it is if they see some expert has written something that kind of gives them a clue to what they wanted to say, right? So, for example, this says that industry analysis, whether it's from a well-known bank or an insurance company, as long as it's intellectually objective and convincing to the readers, they're much more likely to share that, right? Which goes, if I look at it, the contrast I would make is, if you look at the fourth one, there is perspectives on social issues, right? And a lot of native advertising in India we see is that, which is not a critique of it, but essentially, which is to say that an X brand is supporting a Y social cause, right? With the idea being that's what people will share, it's absolutely not true. right? If a bank is going to talk about the macroeconomic situation in India and does it with conviction, people will share much more likely to share that than the bank's commitment to, you know, XYZ social cause, right? Again, this is a constant struggle for brands to see that there's no reason to not engage on the topic on which they have the greatest credibility. These are some of the stats. Like I said, time spent on some of our content pieces, this is the average of all, is around 1 minute 20 seconds. That's huge. That's like three television commercials. And click-through rate, which is not a good measure of content ads, is still higher than what it would be for a display ad, right? The terminology I'm using here is specific to scroll, but I can show you later on what this means. Bulletin is purely a native piece that is text, right? And a canvas has an interactive video or any piece of visual information. So going back to the complex argument, so argument number one was that there are ways in which brands are not today using content that they can, right? Which is A, to talk about their core offerings, B, to talk about things that excite people, C, to present it in ways that they will share it. But if I look beyond that, the next level is that where brands can say, all right, there are certain topics over a period of a year that I want to talk about, right? So here is better shown with an example. So I'll take you to GE, which is a campaign that was run around a year and a half back, and it ran for a year. And the campaign was about R&D in India, right? And the idea was that India is, I think, the number one or number two in terms of GE globally in the patents that that are filed. And that, you know, a lot of people are interested in this kind of work that is being done in India, and nobody had ever decided to put a spotlight on it. And what they did end up doing was essentially, you see, one of the ads, this is an entire series of articles done over a year, one every month, you know, and it's all specifically about India. There's a microsite. These ads are published not just on Quartz in India, but in The Economist, a whole bunch of publications. And then finally, there were a series of videos that are still playing out that you will see, right? And so the idea was the G's push on this was not so much about that GE is doing the R&D. It actually was a much broader thing around R&D in India, engineering R&D, right? And these are some of the most read articles we have ever had, at least in that 2 years back, in Scroll or QZ or in India, right? And so this is the idea around R&D, owning a topic, owning the conversation about what is, you know, what will make high quality, high end research in India happen, and what are some of the best case examples of that. So far, there are two things that, you know, are different about India, I argued. One, number one is that it's not really the FMCGs who I see as the early adopters of pieces of the kind I just shared. I still think that FMCGs can do a lot of content advertising, but I think there is a low-hanging fruit for a lot of brands that today are using less effective methods of doing it, right? So we talked a lot about complicated and technology-driven examples. So I want to take another extremely different example, which we think and we know, and we are talking to some brands around this, that there's a lot of interest, for example, is where Indian modern art is headed, right? And doing individual native pieces is not the way that we can actually bring it alive, right? So this is another example of saying, all right, you know, if you're going to reach, say, 100,000 to 200,000 clients for example, a luxury automaker, this makes sense to do it not as a piece around their product, nor a piece about art sponsored by that brand, but about a set of events done over a six-month period that actually amplifies all the messages. I wanted to just quickly show you, when we talk about the ads, what do we mean? We use the terminology canvas, which is like a big engage unit. We think of it as content because if you see all the highlight portions, you can actually engage with all the features of the ad, right? Which you can't do as a normal display ad. Bulletin is a format for sharing complex content. The ad you see here is the one of the most viral pieces that we have ever had. The incredible engineering that can save your life in a car crash. And again, this is not about any particular product, right? So if I had to summarize, I still think that we are at the stage where brands are starting to engage in saying we can use content. The gap I see is that brands are not using their core competence or their core area of credibility. They're often using content as either to do, like either to directly plug a product and or to push a social cause. We think we can be much broader. And it's not just about scroll. If you look at the examples BuzzFeed shared, you know, many of them are of the same type. Number two, I think there is a huge opportunity for lots of brands that either in the IT and engineering sector, in the auto sector, which have expensive products or the price per product is such that they can actually reach any one or every one of their target consumers online, right? The 125, 150 million people are consuming 80%, if not 90% of these offerings.